Welcome to Technozine. If you haven't subscribed our channel yet, please do so while watching this video. Let's start. The ongoing Facebook content debate has been a rather messy and multifaceted one, with plenty of implications and potential social repercussions extending far beyond the website itself. Regardless of whether we approve or not, Facebook has understandably been trying to absolve and distance itself from the ongoing debates regarding post-truth, fake news and other sticky issues of the day. Avoidance, denial, and pleading bystander, however, are not very prospective strategies in the long run. Enter the new downvote inch button, the latest and likely not the last in the company's efforts to mitigate the crisis. It's a new beta feature, currently undergoing testing on around 5% of English-speaking, US Android users of the platform. It is an extra button that appears next to the like and reply buttons on certain content on the platform. Hitting it reveals three options for flagging said content as either offensive, misleading, or off-topic. The idea here, being that Facebook can track these reports and flag posts and even users accordingly. It is somewhat of an update over the current reporting system, but that isn't as important as a few other aspects of the feature. First up, Facebook is once again making it abundantly clear that this is not a dislike button inch. The social giant has already made its stance on the whole Reddit-style rating system on numerous occasions, claiming that all users really needed was the ability to react differently to information. Hence, the still relatively new reaction emojis. Facebook also claims that it already has systems in place that can handle annoying ad and clickbaiting inch, as well as vote baiting, react baiting, and share baiting content on its own pretty well. The downvote inch button seems to be aimed at crowdsourcing complaints to identify objectively false or inappropriately placed and out of context content. In the post-truth inch era, letting users vote on the level of accuracy, relevance, or offensiveness of a certain statement or information is an imperfect solution for an imperfect world. It gets rid of none of the bias involved in the process. At least, as some form of mitigation, it seems that currently Facebook is only trying the button out on comments, on public page posts. Groups posts or those submitted by individuals currently seem to be left out of the new system. This at least implies that the end goal is battling disinformation. We won't dive any further into the issue as it really is a complicated one, but we would love to hear your two cents on the matter. Do you think the downvote inch button is a proper way of dealing with issues, and what issues is Facebook even targeting to begin with? Do you see it working? Tell us in the comments. That's all for now. If you like this video, please like and share our videos. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel to get technology updates in hand. Thank you.